Well, what does the intermolecular potential look like? What do you mean molecules or atoms care about each other? Here's roughly what they look like, and we're going to go into this in great detail at the end of the semester when we come back to quantum mechanics and bonding and really do something quantitative with interactions between atoms and molecules. But at this stage, it won't surprise you to hear that the way in which the energy, potential energy of two particles, atoms or molecules, depends on the distance between them looks like this.
I've known lots of brilliant scientists, but no one like Alex Pines. His ideas have been consistently visionary and revolutionary.
Alex Pines built the foundations of NMR spectroscopy, or nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, with a series of rather astonishing technological innovations. And Alex really, over the past 5 decades, has mentored several people who have pushed the boundaries of magnetic resonance.
He has sought to make this science borderless by his innovations and by inspiring students and colleagues to tackle problems in new, unconventional ways.
I wasn't interested in doing what others were doing. There are too many unsolved puzzles in science for that.
For 50 years, Alexander Pines served on the faculty of Berkeley's College of Chemistry, distinguishing himself in both research and teaching. His legions of graduate students, the self-proclaimed Pine Nuts, are research leaders in academia and industry. A generous anonymous gift enabled the launch in November 2023 of the Pines Magnetic Resonance Center at Berkeley to continue its namesake's commitment to bold science, creative collaboration, and engaged education. Hundreds of researchers, from faculty to undergraduates, already use this facility for fundamental and applied experiments in a range of disciplines. But now the PMRC will bring the power of this technique to more fields of inquiry. In addition to the Pine Nuts, there are Pine Center postdoctoral fellows, dozens of graduate students, and many undergraduates being trained in the theory and practice of magnetic resonance research. Besides developing the next generation of NMR luminaries on its state-of-the-art equipment, the Pine Center will pursue novel research initiatives led by a faculty director and supported by an expert technical staff.
Having a facility like this next door to a prominent national lab positions Berkeley to take magnetic resonance research to new heights of discovery.
Nuclear magnetic resonance relies on spin, a property of particles such as protons and electrons, that causes the particles to rotate like a toy top and act like a magnet when exposed to a strong magnetic field. An MRI scanner works on the same principle to image your body. NMR analyzes liquid or solid substances to determine their chemical and physical properties. A critical and versatile technique, NMR has been used to study protein structure, design biodegradable polymers, and find the best materials for carbon capture or energy-efficient batteries.
I view NMR as an infinite toy store, playground, where you play with nuclear spins in a non-invasive way and listen to the rhythm as the spins resonate in response to radio waves. And by doing so, they reveal details of molecular structure and dynamics. For its first few decades, NMR was used specifically to study liquids. Analyzing solids was considered impossible. So while I was a graduate student at MIT, I discovered a way to do solid-state NMR. And this methodology, cross-polarization, gave us a way to do it with high sensitivity and high resolution. And that ushered in the era of solid-state NMR and its myriad applications in chemistry, all the way from material science to biomedicine.
Alex dedicated his career to advancing NMR to be more accessible and more useful to more people. The Pines Magnetic Resonance Center must carry that tradition into a future of further innovation and application.
At Berkeley, Alex has been truly singular, with very large shoes to fill. I'm proud to follow his unconventional path of science and explore, along with the newly launched Pines Magnetic Resonance Center, new ways to make magnetic resonance spectroscopy more powerful, more portable, and more accessible to a wide variety of researchers, both in and outside Berkeley.